professional, is that my temper often fights against my testimony. And this may not be anything you relate to, but you can substitute in your own temptation. But for me, it's my temper, and it's been that way all my life, and I can go off in a minute. Like, if the wrong thing happens preaching to you, I can go home today, and after inviting people to receive the love of Christ, I could get road rage. And I'll show you one example of this. And I have gotten better, and God is working on me. But he's still working on me. And so the other day, I went to go get Abby from my mom's house, and when I was stopped at a red light, remember, I'm stopped at a red light. When you hear what happens in this story, remember, I'm stopped at a red light. It's not turning red. It wasn't red and now it's green, and I'm texting. I'm stopped at a red light. This punk, and I'm calling him a punk because it's the nicest word I can think of to use right now. There are other ones. That's the one I'm choosing. And this punk kid in his daddy's car, how do you know it was his daddy's car? Because I'm supplying all the details of this scenario based on how I want the scenario to be as I tell the story to you. And so this punk in his daddy's car, and he's got this girl that he's trying to impress, and both of them look pretty young, and he comes, swerves around me at the red light. He's in such a hurry. Such a hurry to go play Candy Crush with his girlfriend. And he swerves, my story. And so he swerves around me, almost like dinks in the front of our car, and something went off in me, and it was a Monday, so I'm sure I was tired from preaching too, but swerves around me. And so, you know, the Bible talks about praying for people, but it also talks about laying hands on people, and both of those are biblical. They're both in there. So I was thinking about the second one, which is in the Bible. So I followed him. And don't ask me how fast I had to go to follow him, but I followed him, and I caught him. And when I caught up with him, I followed him real good, and I had to follow him a little ways, but I followed him, and when I pulled up beside him because he was going to turn, I rolled down my window, and I shouted at him in the back seat, "Hey, don't be such a..." And then when I said what I said next, it wasn't exactly a cuss word. Now, it depends on what part of the country you're from, if you would consider this a bad word or not a bad word. I won't say the word again here, but what I said, he goes, "Chill out, bro." And I said, "No, bro, you need to chill out. You're a little crazy." He said, "No, you need to chill out. You got an elevation sticker on your car."